So, ladies and gentlemen, could I ask everyone to stand, please, to greet your bride? So once again, good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of Warwickshire Registration Service, I would like to welcome you all here today to Warwick House for the marriage of Ahmad and Danny. So could I ask everyone to be seated, please? A marriage may only take place in a building which has been registered. And this place in which you are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. You are all here today to witness the joining in matrimony of Ahmad Zuhair Wanner and Danielle Wilcox. If any person here present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, they should declare it now. Although the civil ceremony is simple and without ritual, the vows that Ahmad and Danny will make are solemn and binding. This is a day they will remember all their lives, and you are all here to share their joy, to wish them well, and to make this a happy and a memorable day for them both. Marriage is desired by two people to share themselves with each other, and a willingness to accept each other for who they are. For Ahmad and Danny, getting married today is a confirmation of the love, respect, and friendship that they have for each other. Now, included in our ceremony today, we have three readings. I'm now going to have our first reading. So can I ask Sarah to come forward, please?
May the sun bring you new happiness by day. May the moon softly restore you by night. May the rain wash away your worries and the breeze blow strength into your being. And all the days of your life, may you walk gently through the world and know its beauty. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be warm for each other. Now there will be no more loneliness. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. Now go to your dwelling to enter the long days of your life together, and may your days be good and long upon the earth.
Thank you very much, sir. Ahmad and Danny, before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make. Marriage in this country is the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. So I'm now going to ask you, Ahmad, and then Danny, if you freely undertake the obligations of marriage, and to declare that you do not know of any lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. So, Ahmad, if you repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Ahmad Zuhair Wanner.
Why I, Ahmad Zuhair Wanner.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Danielle Wilcox.
To Danielle Wilcox.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Danielle Wilcox.
Why I, Danielle Wilcox.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Ahmad Zuhair Wanner.
To Ahmad Zuhair Wanner.
Ahmad and Danny are now going to contract their marriage before you, their witnesses, family and friends. But first of all, it's traditional for me to ask, Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Okay, if you want to come forward there. Take your daughter's hand. And if you place it to Armand's hand. Thank you very much. So Armand, if you want to repeat your marriage vows after me. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Armad Zuhair Wana.
To witness that I, Armad Zuhair Wana.
Do take thee, Danielle Wilcox.
Do take thee, Danielle Wilcox.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Danielle Wilcox.
To witness that I, Danielle Wilcox.
Do take thee, Armad Zuhair Wana.
Do take thee, Armad Zuhair Wana.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
So now we're going to have our second reading. So can I ask Hannah to come forward, please?
Some say love is a river that drowns the tender meat. Some say love is a razor that leaves your soul to bleed. Some say love is a hunger, an endless aching need. I say love is a flower and you its only seed. It's the heart afraid of breaking that never learns to dance. It's the dream afraid of waking that never takes the chance. It's the one who won't be taken, who cannot seem to give, and the soul afraid of dying that never learns to live. So, when the night has been too lonely and the road has been too long, and you think that love is only for the lucky and for the strong, just remember, in the winter, far beneath the bitter snows, lies the seed that with the sun's love, in the spring, becomes the rose.
Marriage is a commitment to life, to the best that two people can find and bring out in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and growth no other human relationship can equal, a physical and emotional joining that is promised for a lifetime. Within the circle of its love, marriage encompasses all of life's most important relationships. A married couple are each other's best friend, confidant, lover, teacher, listener, and critic. Marriage deepens and enriches every facet of life. Happiness is fuller, memories are fresher, commitment is stronger. Even anger is felt more strongly and passes away more quickly. Marriage understands and forgives the mistakes life is unable to avoid. It encourages and nurtures new life, new experiences, and new ways of expressing love through the seasons of life. When two people pledge to love and care for each other in marriage, they create a spirit unique to themselves, which binds them closer than any spoken or written words. Marriage is a promise, a potential, made in the hearts of two people who love, which takes a lifetime to fulfill. Now, Armad and Danny have chosen to exchange rings and make promises to each other. So can I ask Ed to bring the rings forward, please? Okay, Ed, if you want to give Armad Danny's ring first. If you want to put some to Danny's ring. And if you want to say to Danny, I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
And a symbol of our love.
And a symbol of our love.
I promise to laugh with you in joy.
I promise to laugh with you in joy.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grow with you in love.
To grow with you in love.
To be faithful to you.
To be faithful to you.
and to cherish and respect you always.
And to cherish and respect you always.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Thank you. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
And a symbol of our love.
And a symbol of our love.
I promise to laugh with you in joy.
I promise to laugh with you in joy.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grow with you in love.
To grow with you in love.
To be faithful to you.
To be faithful to you.
And to cherish and respect you always.
And to cherish and respect you always.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
The tradition of giving rings is an outward sign to the world of your marriage. It symbolises your love for each other and is a reminder in the years to come of the important step you have taken today. So we're now going to have our final reading. So can I ask Emma to come forward, please?
On your wedding day and every day thereafter, may your home be filled with happiness and your hearts with love and laughter. May each new year together find you more and more in love and bring you all the happiness that you're so deserving of. May the joy of true companionship be yours to share through life. And may you treasure always the day you became husband.
So we would all like to wish you a long and happy marriage. Try to be patient and kind to one another in times of trouble. Keep a sense of humour. And if you do have disagreements, don't be too proud to say sorry. Take care of each other always. So Ahmad and Danny, you have both made the declarations required by law and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your witnesses here assembled. So it therefore gives me great pleasure to announce that you are now husband and wife. You may now kiss your ring.
Thank you.
friends, we've come to the end of our ceremony now, so could I ask everyone to stand now, please? And could I ask you all to join the Dawn and myself to congratulate the new Mr. and Mrs. Wanner.
I'm going to go to the next one. one in the
Hey!
That's a good one.
Yeah, that's a lovely one, that is.
Hi, Ray.
Oh, yeah, that's better.
Yay!
Okay, girls, that's it. I can't tell.
Right, make sure the napkins are stood up on the plates, yeah?
Can someone also help the first
two? I would like to see that as well.
Yeah.
Six candelabras and any of the gold vases.
Yep.
I don't think there's anything else.
يا الغالي كله عشانك يا ابو حميد قمر هلال الليل سعيد والقمر هلال Thank you.
Yeah! Thank you. Thank you. This is probably your cover CD. Okay,
great. It's going.
You can hear me now.
Even more. Hello everyone. Great team up. I'm going to pass you over to the father of the boy for his speech. Hello, and welcome to the band event. But before we go into that, I just can't think I could beat that band that was on tonight. That music was absolutely fantastic. I want everybody to have a round of applause for the music. Right, hello and mahaba.
Well pronounced.
Thank you. For those of you who don't know, my name's Steve and I'm Danielle's dad. I'd just like to welcome everybody here to the wedding of Danny and Armin today. But before we go any further, I'd just like to raise a glass to everybody that couldn't be here today, to have some friends. Thank you. I'd like to thank Teresa, mother of the bride, for steering Danny in the right direction throughout her life and to help mould her in the woman she is today. Thanks, Teresa. I would also like to thank Armin's mum and dad, Fatin, Zahair, and his sister Heba, for all the hard work in making Danny and Armin's day happen today. Yeah, because I know without you they couldn't have done it today. Thank you. And I'd also like to thank everybody who have made the effort to travel a fair distance today to be at the wedding. Thank you. Next one. Have we got any pets in the house?
Pets?
Any pets?
Pets
or sorrows? I'd like to thank Danny's lifelong friends, the pets, for always being there for throughout the journey. And I know Banana is in the house tonight. And what about the bridesmaids? They all look absolutely stunning and beautiful today. Yeah. Be in the dream. I know they've all travelled with Danny on a journey. With Danny on a journey since they were kids, terrorising me and the mum. I know whichever path they take, they'll always be there for each other. And now to the bride, Danielle. How beautiful does Danielle look tonight? Yeah! Danny was born the red one out of the twins. A lot of you might not know what that's about. And for the first 15 years of her life, she used to terrorise me with Natalie. Whether it was deciding to paint the inside of Charlie's shed, which she blank denied. Even though she was covered in paint. To spending hours up on A&E after Natalie whacked around the head with an ashtray. Which was also denied. To driving to Coventry in thick fog when I couldn't see 10 metres in front of my face because she wanted to do football training. I was always terrorised when they were children. Dan, from when you walked into nursery school to the day you graduated in Liverpool, you've done nothing but make us proud. You've worked hard to be where you are today, and how you work even harder to get where you want to be in life. You've done it all with an effort and determination no one can beat. And I'm sure all your pupils will be proud of you, Miss Wanna. Miss, yeah, they're called Miss Dunno. Even though I'm not too good at putting things into words, I'm even worse at writing them down. You will always be my Dan Dan birdie. I love you, Dan Dan. And I've got to shout out a special mention to the uni girls. Because I've been told, if I don't, Rachel's dad's a copper. So, thanks for all making the effort to travel down here today. I would now like to welcome Arvid into my family. From when he phoned me to ask for Danny's hand, I knew how much he cared for her. And I know we will carry on caring for her. Sorry. I know we will carry on caring for her. Well, you better. I could tell when I first met him what a nice man he was. Polite, kind, and a gentleman. I doubt I could find anyone better to look after my daughter. I know with a bit of commitment, hard work, and laughter, you will still be growing chilies together on the balcony till old age. That's unless you get an allotment. Anyway, me and Google come up with a little poem today, Dan. And I'd just like to read it to you. I think that's it. As a babe, we'd sing your lullabies, so proud of our sweet girl, so hopeful for your future, Dan. Wishing you the world. So keen to help you always, yet aware right from the start, one day you'd find your soulmate, someone to share your heart. Ahmed has your hand in marriage now, companionship each day, a loving wife to share his life in every single way. From this day forth, you will spread your wings, a new chapter has begun, but we haven't lost a daughter, no, today we've gained a son. United, you'll take on the world, chase your dreams together, make kaleidoscopes of memories, and cherish them forever. We know that you'll always be there for him, as he'll be there for you. You'll always be our little girl. We'll always be there too. Anyway, that's enough from me. But before I hand over to Ahmed, the groom, I'd like everybody to stand and raise a glass to the happy couple, to the rest of their happy lives together. Danny and Ahmed. Danny and Ahmed. Right, I'll pass you on to Ahmed now. Thank you.
Fantastic speech, Steve. Thank you very much. I think that's three daughters down and one to go. Yes, Emma. So I'll start with it. On behalf of my wife and I. I'd like to welcome all of our guests from far and wide. We even have a few Olympians in the crowd today. Thank you for spending the day with us. It wouldn't be the same without you all here. The Zephyr was something to remember. It's a lot of fun, and you don't need a sauna when you have a Zephyr. I'd like to thank Danny's family for welcoming me in and making me feel at home with them. They're a really great bunch, who are caring and open, qualities that have clearly been passed down to my wife. Yeah! To both sets of parents, thank you for raising us, steering us as much as you could onto the right road through life. We're here because of all you've done for us, so thank you. Organising a wedding is of course a big task, and by the look of it, it's going okay so far. So thank you for all of those involved, from everything from dress shopping to tying the beautiful favours. And in particular, a special thanks to my mum, who's worked tirelessly on all the little details that make a wedding special. I'd also like to mention the family who couldn't be with us here today. We're thinking of you. So I'd like to take a toast to the families.
The families.
Some of you came to Danny's Arabic henna. I was only in and out for a dance and to cut the cake, but I've been told the rest of it was a great party. So something that Danny won't forget. So thanks to all involved. There's a large group of girls responsible for taking Danny away on 4 additional separate endings, which also deserve a mention. The uni girls. The petals. And of course, the bridesmaids. Yes, you all heard me right. That's 5 Hindus in total. It's a testament to how caring and considerate a group that Danny has around her that they organised such wonderful and enjoyable weekends for her, all as surprises. Although she suspected, I was asked to sleuth her commitments and book out her calendar for Hindus twice. You're a great bunch, you all look fantastic tonight, and I'm sure you'll be showing us all your moves on the dance floor later and for years to come. And maybe some karaoke as well from the sound of it. To all of my friends, and in particular Scrim, thank you for all you've done in the background and for taking me on a magic carpet ride to Berlin for the stag. The less said about that, the better. And now to my bride. Yay! My wife. She's been getting more and more excited lately about Arabic phrases like the bride is very pretty, or words like Habibti, Galbi and Aris that she's been hearing on a few of the Arabic songs. She overheard my grandmother on the phone asking, Shlon her halwa? Is she pretty? And she understood. I'm sure you'll all agree, hiya kullish halwa today. Nothing. Nothing could have prepared me for what I saw when she walked down the aisle. What a fantastic dress. I'm probably going to step on it later, so sorry for that. Thank you for marrying me, Danny. You've made me a happy man today and for a lifetime to come. As Danny's family and friends can attest, I've never known someone as selfless and caring as Danny. It genuinely brings her joy to help others and see others happy. She'll lend out her brand new clothes, give away the last tea bag in the box, or give you the last roller in the pack. That's one of the many reasons I love her. That said, there is a fiery, driven side to her when her mischievous alter ego, Libby, comes out. When it really matters, Libby gets her way. She genuinely keeps a rounder's bat in the boot of her car. Danny's been picking up some Arabic cooking, and although I maintain I taught her a little few things at the start, she's definitely surpassed me now. Danny, I love your cooking. May that forever continue. She's also so mindful, positive and grateful for the everyday things. A few times when I've gone to take the elevator, she's pulled me towards the stairs saying something like, "We're so lucky to be able to use our legs. Take the stairs with me, one day we won't be able to." Then sprints off. It's qualities like this that made me confident she'll be a good wife and a companion for a lifetime. So just before I hand over to the best man, Squim, who I hope will be kind, I'd like you to charge your glasses and be upstanding. May we enjoy the journey of life together as husband and wife, and to all of the adventures that it will throw at us. To our adventure.
Hello everyone, Ahmed's already introduced me. I'm Squim, I'm Ahmed's friend from Stull. I've known Danny for a short time. I'm lucky enough to say a few words in front of you today. First of all, I'm honoured to be able to say a few words here today. Everyone has put on a good show, so thanks everyone for making it happen. Ahmed, Danny is brilliant. She looks fantastic today, and you both look delighted. So congratulations to you both. Also, Ahmed, mate, you're punching with your weight, so... I'm going to speak on behalf of my friends from Birmingham and say that we were all absolutely delighted when you said you were going to marry Danny, because we're going to welcome her into the gang. She's very funny and we're absolutely delighted. The bridesmaids look great as well. Obviously a lot of thought and preparation has gone into making this day happen. From what my wife said, you all had a great time on the hen do and you're all really supportive friends. I'm sure you'll maintain your grace and decorum on the dance floor right until the last song. So let me bring you on to introducing you to the legend that is Ahmed Wanner. Some of you may have known Ahmed for much longer, but my first encounter with the legend was when we met in Year 7 of Five Ways School. He scrubs up well today, but please believe me when I say this hasn't always been the case. Over the years, he has experimented with a range of different facial and hairstyles. Some have been hit, some have been missed. But luckily for you, he got rid of the unibrow for today. I'd also like to apologise, Danny. This isn't the first time Ahmed has been a success with the ladies. He cleared up at sixth form with his gangster swagger and more importantly, his signature catchphrase. Picture this, a packed assembly hall full of two entire girls' school sixth forms. A situation Ahmed used to refer to as wall-to-wall fitties. And an opportunity which would not present itself soon again. Ahmed saw his moment, found a reason to get on stage, grabbed the microphone, and shouted a well-known, popular rap lyric. G-Unit? Of course, it was very awkward. And any lesser guy would have been not bad by this. But we're talking about the legend of Ahmed Wanner. At university, Ahmed decided to up his game, take a more sophisticated approach, and make friends in a more grown-up way. He selected his best skin-tight t-shirt, ironed his orange jeans, secured them with a belt attached with his signature style to the side, groomed his unibrow. One final glance in the mirror, and then watered the plants. He strutted like he owned the place into the student union. There he sailed effortlessly from new acquaintance to new acquaintance, charming them with his wit, and then finally sealing the deal by handing them a business card. Jokes aside, I think we're all here today to celebrate two people that are in love. Armand's my mate and Danny has made him really happy, and that's obvious. I feel like I've known Danny for a lot longer than I have. They obviously have a lot of fun together and are supportive of each other, which is what really matters. And that's where I'd like to finish. So to the happy couple, I would like to propose a toast. In Arabic, I think it's Tuel Saha. So to Mr. and Mrs. Weller, Tuel Saha and cheers.
I'm not sure what happens now, so enjoy your tea for a bit until we change the room around and get the dance floor sorted. Thank you. Thank you.
Life is a whole. then we come to the we come
three
to
cheers for Miss Julia.
Cheers.
Yeah, congratulations, Armin and Danny. I think it's on. Congratulations. Cheers. Have a good life together.
You guys make an amazing couple. I know you have an amazing life together. And yeah, we're just
welcome to the gang.
We're doing another one.
Cheers.
I'll join you guys there shortly. 1, 2, 3.
Mr. and Mrs. Wanna, congratulate you, Danny and Ahmed, on such an amazing day. Thank you for making us part of it all. We've absolutely loved it. We wish you all the absolute luck, happiness, love, health, wealth in the world. You deserve it more than anything because we are.
You almost till I die. I almost till I die. I know I am. I'm sure I am. I almost till I die.
Okay, Danny, I hope you had a fabulous day. Right, sorry I couldn't be with you. You know you're my favourite, always.
Oh. Literally, them two having a conversation, Dad.
Are you going to book your funeral this afternoon?
Danny, I mentioned you in my speech earlier on, Les.
Yeah?
I did.
You didn't tell me that I would choose my favourite.
No. So a bit different to that. But
he said that you had to be included because you was a copper.
Yeah.
And that was it, honest.
No, Rachel had to be included. Otherwise, you'd say to me.
This is like old times, isn't it, Dad? All we need now is Natalie to start a fight, and then we can all.
Yeah, we can all jump.
All of us can go knocking in, Dad.
It's all right. Right, it's a bit like old times, except it's not raining, and we're not stood on a touchline arguing the toss with the referee.
Les, I remember that one you had on Dave Bilbo. I remember it. I had to hold you back, mate.
when I told the linesman from Levington that I was going to push the flag where the sun doesn't.
Yeah, that's right. And the bloke from Wolverhampton when I was kicking off, and he got the ball in his hand and it looked like an egg.
Yeah.
And I sort of stepped back.
And you never got me the sack on.
No, mate, no. Look after you, mate, honestly.
Once this goes public, you'll get sacked.
Legend, mate, legend. Anyway.
We love you, Dan.
Danny, Ahmed, have a brilliant night.
Catch up with you later.
Okay, Liz.
Top. Ahmed and Danny, we love you. This is from the old Villa crew, Bilbo, Kaza, the lot. Not the dickheads, the good ones. This is from the Villa under-14s, Dan and Ahmed.
That's it.
On your touchline, Danny, when you never... Dan, this message here is for when you never kept your line properly because you has been never got back in time. And I told you this.
Class. I would never have took her off. You know I would never have taken her off. It was Bilbo's fault.
Yeah.
All Bilbo's fault.
Political.
Bilbo's
too fault. Political. Les,
I'll see you later.
Alright, take
legend,
care.
Legend, man. Speak to you later, man.
Up the villa, Dan.
See you later.
Danny and Ahmed, I'm only doing this because Dean said I didn't have the bottle. So, here is my bra. So, that's what I'm about to do. Sorry.
Hey, Petal!
It's your wedding.
Happy
it's
wedding day!
We're having the most wonderful time. And you are as well.
We're not really sure what to say.
No, we don't know what to do. But
you're married!
You're married now!
I'm about to marry.
And it's amazing. And we love you. And we love you both so much. And
happy wedding and marriage
and
all of the above
and everything.
Happy adventure.
And we'll be there for all of it and so will these.
We love you.
We will.
Cheers, Bam Bam and Ahmed.
Hi, Danny and Ahmed. We just want to say that we are absolutely privileged to be a part of a special day today, especially me as a bridesmaid. Honestly, don't think there's a better couple suited to each other than you two are. We know you'll have a fantastic life, happy memories and adventures together. So we love you both loads. Cheers.
I agree.
So Ahmed, just a little message to say to you on our wedding day. So far it's been the day of our lives. So much stress, worry, thought has gone into it. But I think and I hope that you think the same, that it's all been worth it and this is just the start of the next chapter and I can't wait for what it's got to bring. Thank you.
Hi Dan. Thanks for saying yes today. You've made me a happy man. Hopefully for today and for the rest of our lives together. I can't wait to go on loads of holidays, travel the world, do lots of adventurous things with you. Thank you for being my wife.